Hey guys, my name is Massimio, and this week in Rainbow Six Siege has been fairly interesting, to say the least. You guys may have noticed that some glitches are going around. Probably the most prominent one right now is that players have somehow been able to figure out how to glitch out Clash. Essentially, they've been able to make it where you can use her primary weapon, so she can take out other players, but everyone else, so everyone on the offensive team, sees her with her shield directly in front of her. And so not only does she get the protection of her shield, which already is difficult to deal with, but now she can just use her, I guess, secondary weapon in this point, to take anyone out that tries to actually contend with her. And so the question that I wanted to bring up today is, should Ubisoft remove Clash for a short period of time, basically disable this operator from ranked or even in casual, because it's upsetting to even have this happen in casual? Should they remove her from the game temporarily so that they can focus on fixing her and then reintroducing her when that actually occurs? Now, some of you are probably thinking right now that this seems a bit extreme. Not everyone is taking advantage of this glitch. A lot of people enjoy playing as Clash. That's their favorite character. And this seems to be taking things too far. And I do agree with you to some extent, and we'll get to that here in a second, but the reason why I've made this recommendation is that I really do believe that this is game breaking. People are losing matches because of this. Now, thankfully, Ubisoft has reached out and stated that they are aware of all these issues and they're going to try to resolve them as soon as possible. And that's fantastic news. But the question is how long is that actually going to take? Is it going to be a few days? Is it going to be a couple of weeks? We really don't know. There could be a really large systemic issue that they have to resolve, and it could take much longer than that. And so until then, what's the harm in removing her for a short period of time? A lot of people play Rainbow Six Siege because they want to be successful with their matchmaking. They want to rise through the ranks, and I don't blame them. That is a key component of what makes this game so much fun. Everyone is striving for that next goal. They want to get better and better, and seeing that higher rank is one way of visualizing that. And so to have a game-breaking bug like this that could ruin that experience for a lot of players, I believe that that warrants a dramatic response. Now, what's funny about this is that I believe that this isn't the only time that Ubisoft had to remove an operator from the rotation because of some large issue. When Habana was first introduced, and I'm only basing this off of memory, so correct me if I'm wrong, her pellets and her gadget was causing some pretty large problems, and so they removed her for a couple of days to resolve that. And while yes, a couple of people were upset because she was new, a lot of people like to play as her, to actually fix the issue then and then reintroduce her, I felt like was a decent way of handling things. Now, I know that some people will say that this will never happen because people have paid to play as Clash. Either they purchased the season pass or they bought her outright to play as this character. And I do understand this mentality. Like I said, this isn't a clear and cut issue. I know there are two different sides, but at the same time, everyone has purchased and played Rainbow Six Siege. Why should the people that just bought Clash specifically warrant or be better than everyone that's actually bought in the game? Like, everyone had to buy Rainbow Six Siege, and so why should their experience be lessened because of this large glitch? Now, sadly, that isn't the only issue that is happening right now. You may have noticed that some players have a deployable shield in front of their face, and just like Clash, they're able to use their primary weapon, but they have the protection of a deployable shield in front of their character. You can, if you get lucky, kind of shoot at their feet, for example, to take them out, but of course that puts anyone on the receiving end at a massive advantage. This is clearly an exploit. This is something that people are taking advantage of right now. If you've been playing Rainbow Six Siege, then this definitely isn't your first rodeo. The shield glitch has popped up every once in a while. Ubisoft will solve it, but then for some reason it comes back a couple seasons later. It doesn't seem like this is any different. I don't know what it is about this gadget, but Ubisoft clearly has a hard time making it work the way that it's supposed to be. Either from people using it to jump onto locations that they're not supposed to get into, that's been a problem since the very beginning, or to have glitches like this where it protects the player from all incoming damage. And so I'm hopeful that when this thing does get its rework, which I believe is either this season or the next one, this will no longer be a problem. What I find really interesting about this is that when Ubisoft was having all these problems, like with the deployable shield, they wrote into the patch notes that they were working on some infrastructure that would allow them to remove or turn off gadgets for a short period of time when something like this did occur. And so the question that I have for Ubisoft is where did this go? Maybe they weren't able to actually create a system that would allow them to turn it off and on whenever they wanted to. Maybe there isn't enough people that are actually taking advantage of the glitch to actually remove it from the game because the vast majority of the player base is using the gadget the way that it's supposed to be. I'm not really sure, but if this is actually a serious problem, where did that infrastructure go? I feel like that would be a great way of going about it. Another way that Ubisoft could resolve this is by suspending players who are constantly taking advantage of these exploits to win their games. Now, I realize not everyone is going to be on board with this idea. People get worried as soon as that occurs, is like, if I accidentally do this glitch, am I now going to get banned? Well, no. People that are using these exploits over and over and over again, it's going to be obvious when they do that. Those are the people that are getting flagged by other players, you know, reported for toxic behavior, for example. Ubisoft can look into their accounts, see what they're doing, and if that is actually true, especially if there's video evidence of them always doing it in a ranked game, then I think Ubisoft should actually take the appropriate response and do something about it. I don't think they should be banned outright from the game forever, but a short suspension to try to curb that kind of behavior, I don't think is the worst idea. I don't want to go as far to say that people that do this are essentially using third-party cheats to win their games, but it's kind of on the same level. Yes, you might not be using a program to be able to make yourself immune to damage from in front of you while also using your primary weapon. You're using the in-game mechanics to glitch it out, but at the same time, you're using an exploit to cheat in the game, and so I feel like there should be some repercussions. Now, I realize not everyone is going to be on board with that, and honestly, I don't feel like this is even necessary if they just took the steps that we talked about earlier just to remove the gadget or the operator for a short period of time. But if they can't or won't do that for whatever reason, this could be a way to try to stop that kind of behavior, especially in ranked. Now, one ray of hope to all of this is that next season, players will actually have a tool at their disposal to be able to work around these problems, and that is the pick and ban system. If you guys aren't aware, the pick and ban will allow you to do just that. At the start of a match, each side will be able to choose one defender and one offensive character that is eliminated from the pool of selection. This means that you can either eliminate someone that is either overpowered, so if they introduce someone who was just game-breaking in that sense, you can no longer have to deal with that operator on offense. That's awesome. Or if something like this occurs, where there is a large game-breaking bug, you can of course avoid them as well. And so having this tool at our disposal, not only to just allow us to change the meta in a meaningful way on the maps, but also avoid glitches or people that are using these kind of exploits for specific operators, this is going to be a great assistance. The thing is, though, is that this only affects operators. There's no way for us to actually, you know, get rid of gadgets or things that are other also causing issues. And so this isn't, of course, a all-encompassing solution. There needs to be something a bit further. In general, though, I really do believe that something needs to be done. We as a community can, of course, do stuff on our end. I know that some people say that they will only use a glitch if someone on the other team is using a glitch, fighting fire with fire. But honestly, that doesn't really get us anywhere. If you fight fire with fire, then everything is on fire. This is kind of the same mentality with toxic behavior. Someone will TK a match and then they think that warrants them being able to TK everyone else. It's like, no, you're just perpetuating the issue. As soon as people see that this glitch is in a game, if more and more people start to use it, it becomes a larger problem than if everyone justifies, hey, I'm using it because you're using it, then every game is just ruined after that. And while, yes, the people that are using these exploits and cheating are really the heart of the issue, they're the catalyst, the thing that gets the ball rolling, don't lower yourself to their level. Rise above it. Don't get down in the mud just because they're down there. It's not going to be fun for anyone. Once again, I feel like this is the reason why there should be some consequences for people that are using these exploits to cheat. There should be a brief suspension to try to stop this at its source. But of course, that is just my opinion. All in all, though, there really is a bunch of ways for Ubisoft to try to resolve these issues. I understand they're doing everything they can on their end to fix the actual glitches themselves, but until then, a lot of people are not even playing the game because of these very problems, which of course isn't good for the health of the game in general. And so I think some further steps are necessary. But yeah, guys, that is about it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed. Let me know what you thought about what we discussed in today's video. Do you think that Ubisoft should try to take it to the next level and implement some of the stuff that we talked about in today's video? Do you think that's going too far? Do you think that this is something that is just a part of multiplayer games and we should all just kind of accept it until the fix finally arrives? How do you think Ubisoft should fix it in the future? Give me your guys' thoughts down below. But yeah, guys, that is it for today's video. I thought that this would be an interesting topic to talk about, and so I hope you guys enjoyed. But until next time, have a good one and take it easy.